Hello everyone, today I would like to present to you the topic of private asset option for Google API and services. So let us start with the problem statement. When you start to studying this topic, the Google private asset option, this means your company has the demand to use Google service or UND service hosted on Google Cloud Platform. And the easiest way is to connect your company infrastructure, including the resource hosted on-prem or the resource hosted on Google Cloud Platform to Google service via public internet. However, due to some compliance or policy requirement or data security reason, some company wish to avoid exposure of their data to the public internet entirely. And therefore, it is required to have only internet IP address in your company resource and connect to this service privately. Addressing this requirement, Google have provided different options for private asset. However, the explanation in their official document are quite difficult to understand, and also it's difficult to catch the difference between them and the most fit use case. So for this video, I will explain to you the detail of these options, the comparison as well as the suggested use case. The two main sources that I use for this video would be the official document of Google private asset option and one YouTube video from Google Cloud Tech, asset your Google or third party managed service privately. So this is the agenda. First, I will explain the private option in detail, include four of them: private service connect, private Google asset, private service asset, serverless VPC asset. And you can see even the name are sometimes similar and confusing. So moving on, I will do the comparison between them and provide to you the suggested use case. And finally, I will review some questions on exam topic related to this private asset option. So let's move on to number one. Before going into detail, let's start with some basic terminology. In the modern architect, you will often hear about microservice. Microservice has itself various benefits. And I will just mention two. It could be independently deployable and scalable and so on, so many more. In the microservice architect, applications are built and deployed in highly decoupled, in small component and focus on the service only. So you can see here multiple service, and each of these components will connect to each other to complete one complete process. And to simplify, I will use only one service connect to the other. And in this connection, there's always one consumer and use the service of each other, and I will call producer. For consumer, I will from now on use the blue box, and for producer, I will use the red box color. And for the entire of the four options that we're going to discuss, we will stay at the consumer service area to see how can we connect to the other producer service privately. So as we already have some basic understanding of the microservice, let us see now what could be the consumer and producer service and where they can be hosted. I have here the box in black color of the Google Cloud Platform. So the first service of the consumer could be hosted in on-prem where you have not migrated to the Google Cloud Platform or even do not have plan to do so. The second service could be placed on your old company VPC. And here I take two examples of the Google Cloud Computing Engine. So at the first step to establish the private connection from on-prem, you should set up the VPN or interconnect connection to your old VPC. And at the second step, you should set up the internet IP address for all the resources belonging to your old company VPC. Besides these two kinds of hosting play, you can also deploy some application or service hosted in some serverless platform like Application Engine, Cloud Function, or Cloud Run. So here the three box in blue color demonstrating the where the consumer service could be hosted. Now we're moving on to the producer. For the producer service, there are also multiple types of them, and let us go step by step. Number one is the managed service, or sometimes called Google API, hosted in Google infrastructure or for some document is called Google Service Network, please remember that this service is sitting outside Google Cloud Platform. And this service is funded from the computing resource such as the computing engine or Kubernetes by an internal Google proxy. Some examples can be mentioned like Google Cloud Storage, Cloud Spanner, or BigQuery. Furthermore, we will go to the service sitting inside Google Cloud Platform. Number one is the managed service by Google, hosted on the Google Cloud infrastructure. So this service, you can imagine that it's just the same like your old company VPC. It just happened to be the service of Google. Some example like Cloud SQL Private Kubernetes Cluster. The second one is the service belong to the third-party VCP. Here again, the service located in the VPC of the third party from the technical is the same. From the business point of view, this service does not belong to Google nor belong to your company. Last but not least, the service is your own in your own company VPC. However, due to organization, you also have different VPC and require the resource to be accessed in this service also privately. So because of the nature, the same nature in the technical, sometime in my following presentation, you will see that I group all service together and call them the producer VPC, just like that. And for the VPC, where in blue color, I will call them the consumer VPC. Let us start now with the first option, Private Service Connect. This is the most generic option to let the consumer connect to the producer privately. This will be done by creating the private endpoint using the global internet IP address within your VPC network. You can also assign the DNS name to the internet IP address of the endpoint with a meaningful name. This name as well as the endpoint IP address will be internal to the VPC of the consumer as well as to on the on-prem to connect to that via VPN or interconnect. You can also control the traffic which go to which endpoint as well if you would have multiple one. This option using the private endpoint will give you the access to all Google API and service that are included into the API panels. For more information, you can go to the official document. For the consumer, first of all, you must have the internal IP address. Optionally, you can give it the external IP. However, the connection between the consumer to the endpoint is always private. So in short, irrelevant whether or not the consumer have the external IP address or not, the traffic between the consumer to the private service endpoint is always internal. The external traffic to the producer will be taken care of by the service endpoint itself. With this, the consumer got secure by not publishing their IP address to the producer directly. As next, I will present to you three use cases using the Private Service Connect. The first one is the resource under the VPC of your company going to access to the Google API sitting in the Google Service Network. This will allow you to access to own API and service under API panel. The second one is quite the same. However, it also allows you to restrict to some specific API or service that you want your resource to access to as well as their specific region. As the third one, the resource of the VPC network going to access to the service of another VPC, or we call producer VPC. First of all, let us see how the resource sitting inside your consumer VPC connecting to the Google API in the Google service network. On the right hand side is the picture from the Google official document depicting this scenario. Here we have two computing engines with only the internet IP address sitting inside the subnet of your VPC network. In the same VPC network, we create a private service connect endpoint with the global internet IP address. The connection between this VM to the endpoint is definitely private, while the external one is managed by the ending point to the Google Service Network service. With this, VM will not expose the IP address to this service. As already mentioned, The private service connect endpoint will help you to connect your own Google API within the API partner. But what if you want to restrict the access to only a certain API and service, and also restrict the region that it should access to? So let's move on to the next scenario, the use of private service connect with the consumer of the HTTPS service control. So the internal HTTPS load balancer will act at the private service connect endpoint. This will help you to restrict the access to only a certain API and service that you wish for. Furthermore, it will help you to configure to define the region of the service. So take a look at the picture. We have two VMs sitting in a subnet of your consumer VPC, and both of them are in the region US Central 1. With the use of the internal HTTPS load balancer, you can configure which service you allow this VM to access to. In this case, it's Cloud Logging, PubSub, and Cloud Spanner. Furthermore, you also allow to set up the region of this service, and you can see here the US Central 1, the same region of the VM, can be set up for all of these services, so allow the access of this service only in this region, and for that you can gain the benefit of the latency. On the left hand side, you can see the on-prem network connect to the VPC with the cloud interconnect or VPN. With this, the host from on-prem network can also access to the Google API in Google Service Network with the same way that VM access into. We already reviewed two use cases where the consumer resource access into the Google API. Let's see how the consumer resource can also access to the other service sitting inside one of the VPC of the Google Cloud platform. So let's review one use case where the private service connect is made for. So here the picture. On the left hand side, you see the consumer VPC. On the right hand side, you see the producer VPC, where we have here the instant group which going to provide the service. To explore the service, we will need to create a service attachment. This service attachment will refer to the service load balancer forwarding rule and then going to the backend service. From the consumer VPC, as always, we must create the private service connect endpoint, which will connect to the resource of the subnet, the VM here with the private IP address. And to access the service of the producer, then this endpoint must refer into the service attachment of the producer. We have learned that the consumer resource must have the internal IP address and can have the external IP address optionally. With the private service connect, then do not matter whether the resource having the external IP address or not, the connection between them and the endpoint is always internal. However, what if now you wish to have another kind of configuration? Like for those resource with internal IP address to set up the connection privately, and the resource with the external IP address to set up the connection publicly. With this requirement, we've been going to the second option, is private Google access. So let's go into detail. The private Google access will allow you to connect to Google API within the Google Service Network. The VM instance that have only the internal IP address and no external IP address can reach to the external IP address of the Google API with this option. The private Google access have no effect on the instance that have the external IP address. This means for those that has external IP address, the connection to the Google API is always publicly. For those consumer resource in GCP, the private Google access will be set up on the subnet where the resource is based on. Here you can see the subnet with the configuration of the private Google access set to on. For on-prem, this is the configuration of the DNS, firewall rule, and the routers. Please remember the on-prem have to connect to the VPC with the interconnect or VPN tunnel. Let us review now one of the use case using the private Google access. We have here two subnets, each of them with two VM. A1, A2 sitting in subnet A with a private Google access set to on. B1, B2 sitting in subnet B with a private Google access set to off. Let's review the traffic for each of them. For VM A1, it can access to the Google API with the internet IP address. For the reason, it has only internet IP address and the private Google access set to on. VM B1 is go to nowhere because it have only internet IP address and the private Google access set to off. For A2 and B2, both of them will go to the Google API as well as internet with the public IP address. This means that does not matter whether private Google access set to on or off. Even when it's set to on, and for A2 with the public IP address, it have no impact on this VM. Third option, private service access. In some case, the service producer can offer the service with the internet IP address that are hosted in a VPC network. For example, this service can generate it just to serve the resort within this consumer VPC. And the same, the consumer also want to use the internet IP address to access the service in the producer. In this case, the best fit scenario is to use the VPC peering. This will allow the internet connection. However, if you know about the VPC peering already, you would know that it's just not a simple configuration. This is complete setup where you also have to understand how to import and export the custom route between these two VPC. So Google have the solution for that. They introduce the private service access, which is the configuration in the producer service side to set up the VPC peering automatically. So for that, you don't have to worry about the import or export of the custom route between two sides. The access from on-prem, which connect to the VPC with the VPN tunnel and the interconnect also possible as well. Don't forget to export the custom route of the on-prem to the producer VPC. So let's go into more detail. We have on the left-hand side a customer VPC network and on the right-hand side is the producer. Within the customer, we have one resort VM1 with the internet IP address. On the producer side, when we try to create an instance of the cloud as well, there are one configuration when you select the internet IP. This will help you to automatically generate the VPC network peering for two VPC, and this will allow you to create the private access traffic between two VPC, and you don't have to be worried about any further exchange of the routing customized between two of them. Last option, serverless VPC access. In the previous three options, we have discussed how the resort in your VPC and the on-prem can connect to the other service. So with the last option, serverless VPC access, we will discuss how your application, which you deploy on a serverless environment, such as Cloud Run application engine or Cloud Function, can access to the resort in a VPC network. And in this case, it could be your company or VPC as well. Requests can send to the VPC network and never explode to the internet, and the communication through the serverless VPC access can have less latency compared to internet as well. And for the on-prem access, the serverless environment can also access to your on-prem host through the cloud VPN tunnel or interconnect. So let's see one specific use case. Here you have your application deployed on application engine, Cloud Function or Cloud Run. The ServerNet VPC access will be based on the resource connector. This connector, you have to create in your own project, attached in the specific VPC and to a specific region. So when you create and deploy application on a serverless environment, you have to configure your ServerNet service to use the connector. And for that, it will take care of the outbound network traffic to the other resource sitting in the VPC network. And on the left-hand side, the serverless can also access to the internet via public IP. Let us do now the comparison between four options and also review the suggested use case. Actually, all the information already available within the document of Google Private Access option. When you go there, you can see all the options with all the details. However, for simplification, I put all of them in one table and let us review together. So here is the table with the blue color indication the information for consumer and the red color for producer as we defined from the beginning. For the first option, Private Service Connect, it allows you to access from the Google Cloud resource or from on-prem resource as well. The resource must have the internal IP address, as optionally, it can have the external IP address as well. However, irrelevant to whether the resort have the external IP address or not, the connection is private. And regarding the connection, it's use the Private Service Connect endpoint. For producer, it allow you to accept most of the Google API and service, and also the service got published from the VPC. For example, the VPC of Google from third party or from your old company. One remark, if you want to limit some kind of API or the region that the API should be accessed, then please use the internet HTTPS load balancer. For the second option, Private Google Access, it allows you to access from the Google Cloud resource with only internet IP address. This will use the subnet configuration where your resource hosts into. From the producer, it allows you to access most of the Google API and service. And for remark, the access for on-prem also possible with the configuration of DNS, firewall rule, and routers, and it's not the configuration of the subnet. So, moving to the Private Service Access, it will allow you to connect from your Google Cloud VM instance with internet IP address or, again, optionally, external IP address. It will based on the VPC network peerings. So in principle, this option is the configuration from the producer side and it will generate the VPC network peering automatically for you. From the producer, then the it will allow you to access Google or third-party service which allow the Private Service Access, so just some of them. For the remark, the access from on-prem also possible, but you need to explore the custom route to the producer VPC. For serverless VPC access, it allows you to set up the access from Cloud Run, App Engine, or Cloud Function. It will based on the connection. This connection must be set up within your project, your VPC, and a specific region. Both thus, this will allow you to access to Cloud VM instance with or without external IP address and also even on-prem host. Finally, let us review some questions of the exam topic. The question 151. Your company uses the App Engine standard and the project have the VPC fully connected to the company on-prem through the Cloud VPN tunnel. And you want to enable the App Engine application to communicate with the database sitting on-prem. What should you do? So here is referring to the service on the serverless accessing into the service of your on-prem. So there are no other option but the serverless VPC access. The question 52, is it not allowed to set up the public internet for your computing engine? And you do not have the VPN connection, yes, to your on-prem. And you need to install a specific software to the computing engine, what do you do? So here the answer is quite long, but I will just go directly to the analyst. The computing engine allows to have only the internet IP address, but need to access somewhere to get the file for installing. So the answer here is actually A. You first upload the required installation file in the cloud storage. You set up the VM with the internet IP address and set up the subnet where it's sitting on with the Private Google Access to on. And with this setup, the Private Google Access will allow the resort with only internet IP address to access to Google service with the engine IP. And for that, it can easily download the installation file to the VM with the internal IP address, no issue, and still can cover the requirement of the policy. So I just finished presenting to you the entire four options for the private asset of Google. I hope it's more or less clear now to all of you. If you like, please have to share, like, and subscribe to our channel, and we will work on more useful video. Thank you very much.